Hi, and welcome back to My Excel Online. Today, we are going to cover our third installment of our dashboard series. We are going to be inserting a few graphs and some slicers and some sparklines. So just a quick review, here's what we built so far in dashboard part one. We built all of these boxes over to the right that gives different totals. Last week, we built this map and this slicer over here so that you're able to see the data by state or clear the filter and go back to viewing all of your data. Originally, we had created the dates from and to. This cell is a minimum of all the dates that we're looking at, whereas this cell is a maximum of all the dates we are looking at. So just so you know where we are going with dashboard three, we are going to add these three graphs where we're looking at numbers by date, numbers by date and salesperson, and numbers by state on a transactional level. So for example, what was sold in New York on the first day, the second day, the third day, and what do those numbers look like? Over here on the left, we are going to put in some slicers so that we are able to narrow down our data and have the dashboard be more interactive. And over here on the right, we are going to have sparklines to give us a quick view of what kind of trends can be seen with our data. So let's now see how to insert some graphs. Click up here and go to insert and go to this bar chart right here. And I'm going to select a 2D column. So I'm going to right click this chart and go to select data. On this screen, I'm going to select the up arrow, go over to my all sales final, and I'm going to select column B, including the header cell, which says date. And then I'm going to hold down the control key and select the amount sold, the dollars earned, the cost and the profit, and drag all the way down. And then I'm going to click this box again. And then I'm going to click OK. Now I will be returned with this chart right here. I'm going to move it over here so that it's easier to see. I'm going to click on the chart, go to chart design, and go to switch row column. Now, if you look at my data, I will be seeing all of my data by date, and I will also be seeing a breakdown of each of the columns that I have picked in my data set. So I want to see the amount sold, the dollars earned, the cost, and the profit. Now this color scheme could match the color scheme of our dashboard a little bit better. So I would like to click on my chart and go up to chart design and go to this option that says change colors. And in here, I'm going to pick a blue so that it matches my dashboard a little bit better. I can also format my dates along the x-axis by double clicking the x-axis and having the properties show up over here to the right. I'm going to scroll down to number, and right here, I would like that format code to be mm/dd. And then I'm just going to hit add. And if you can see over here, my date format has changed a little bit to be a little bit more readable and give us some more space inside of our chart. So this is numbers by date. I'm going to change the chart title to reflect what the chart is telling me. I'm also going to make this chart as wide as my map over here. So if I click on the map over here and I click on this icon and I go to size, I can see that the height is 3 inches and the width is 5.25 inches. So if I click over here, click on this icon again, I want the width of this to be 5.25. So that's one of our three charts. We're going to go back over here to the dashboard final and see that there are two more charts and the slicers. So let's add these other two charts down here to our screen. I'm going to right click on the graph that we just made and go to copy and then right click down here and go to paste. So I'm going to right click on the chart area and go to select data. I'm going to click this up arrow here, and now I'm going to pick my date all the way down to the bottom of my pivot table where I can see date and salesperson at the same time. Then I'm going to click this button and say OK. And now you can see that I have the salespeople by date on this chart. However, this chart is only telling me the total profit. If I would like this chart to tell me more information, I will have to go back to my pivot table here and add those columns to my pivot table. So I'm going to right click here and go to show field list. And not only am I going to have the profit on there, but I'm going to put the amount sold, the dollars earned, and the cost. The only other thing I will need to do is edit the label for how this field is being displayed. So if I click on this down arrow here, I'll go to value field settings and make this total amount sold and say OK. If I change this arrow right here and go to view field settings, I will change this to total dollars earned. And if I scroll down one more, I will go to value field settings and change this to total cost and say OK. Close this window. And if I go back to my dashboard, everything will be updated with that information. So this is a numbers by date and salesperson. So finally, I might like to see my numbers by state. I'm going to select this graph, right click, and go to copy, and then click down here, right click, and go to paste. I'm going to right click here and go to select data, and then I'm going to hit edit on this column and go over here and just select states and say okay, and say okay to this screen. Now, I'm not sure how you would like to see your state data, but what I would like to see is every state entry, what my sales looked like by state per entry. If you would like to group the states together and see what the amount sold, the dollars earned, the cost, and the profit would be, then I recommend creating a pivot table and then using that pivot table just like we did with numbers by date and salesperson. So I'm going to move this and line it up with the one above it. Another thing you can do is select this chart and this chart, go up to Shape Format, go to Align, and align the tops of these. Same with this one if you want to make sure they're all lined up. Just select the first one, hold down Control, select the second one, go to Shape Format, Align, Align Top. We can select these two and go to Shape Format and go to Align Right. And we can go to these two and select Shape Format and go to Align Left. And our graphs will be more lined up now. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. So let's review the slicer that we introduced last week. Right now, I'm going to select my date, hold down the Control button, and select all the other data that I used on my first graph. Then I'm going to go up to Insert and go to Slicer. I'm going to select by date and say OK. And then I'm going to right-click on this slicer and go to Cut, and go back to my dashboard and right-click and go to Paste. Now with this slicer, if I pick 7-1, my data will change. If I pick 7-2, my data will change again, 7-6, 7-7. This is happening for all of my data for which I've selected the main table for the data to change. Notice it is not changing by date and salesperson. For that one, I will need a separate slicer. So I'm going to move this one. I'm going to remove this filter and then go back to All Sales Final. This time, I'm going to select my pivot table with all of my data and go up to Insert and go to Slicer. And this time I'm going to pick Salesperson and say OK. I'm going to right click on this slicer and go to Cut, go back to my dashboard, right click, and go to Paste. Now I can see this by Salesperson. If I select Andy, I will only see the days in which Andy had sales. Or if I select Jim, same thing. If I want to select more than one person, remember I can click on this button and I can do a multi-select to see different people by date. And to remove that filter, I just click this button here. I would like for this to look a little more uniform, so I'm going to click on here and go up to Slicer and see that the width of this is 1.63. I'm going to copy that, then I'm going to select this slicer and this one under it. Go back up to Slicer and change the width to 1.63. Then I'm going to hold down Control so I can select all three and go up to Slicer, Align, Right. So now all my slicers are lined up. Another thing I can do is make them just a little bit shorter, but I do want this data to be able to grow. So this size may change once I have more dates in there. Also up here, I would like to change my title. If you look at our final one, we have select date, state, or salesperson to filter graph. So let's copy that and go back to dashboard and paste that text here. And I'll just move the slicers back down. Next, I want to insert a sparkline so I can see a quick data trend, perhaps in my date. So if I click in this cell, I'm going to go to Insert, Line, and select this up arrow. Next, I'm going to go to All Sales Final and select the profits for the pivot table where it's arranged by date. Click this arrow and say OK. It looks like a sparkline was not inserted, but if I go up to Sparkline here and I go to Sparkline Color and change it to white, then I can see that there is a quick sparkline put in there. Now let's see if that data looks right. It looks like there's a peak and then the sales figures go down. So if I look at my data here, it clearly looks like a peak and my data is going down. So that is correct. So in review, we added three new graphs to our dashboard. We added these two slicers over here to be able to look at our data in different ways and make it an interactive dashboard for the user. And over here, we inserted a sparkline so that you could see the trend by date when we're selecting various dates. I hope you've learned a lot about dashboards through our last three lessons. And if you have any questions, please post them below. Thanks, and looking forward to seeing you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.